Welcome back to Hockey Night in Canada, presented by Rogers on a Saturday night in Raleigh. The Hurricanes have hit 11 posts in the postseason. That's number one. Rangers are hitting them two tonight. Second, Vegas. They're already gone. They had 9 posts. Okay, time for Kevin.
So, Tony D'Angelo, very complicated guy, spotted pass. Is that fair to say? Played 3 seasons. Give me some context about this. Played 3 seasons for the Rangers his last full year. 15 goals and 53 points. That's a lot as a defenseman. Then he gets traded, or the next year he plays 6 games. Then he gets...
What happened was they warned him if there are any more incidents that they would buy him out. They would put him on waivers. And so he had an altercation with Alexander Georgiev after a game. The next day, they placed him on waivers. Nobody claimed him, and at the end of the year, they bought him out.
So he played he played 6 games that year. The next year, Carolina, ironically, gives him a chance. Has an unbelievable year point-wise then. Let him go, goes to Philly, great year. And now this year, he comes back to Carolina. He only played 31 games. So there's a history, and at times, we'll show you some clips. I feel like he's a bit unhinged. There's some personal beef here with the Rangers, and they've been chirping at him, he's been chirping at them, but this was a terrible penalty he took last game, spearing a look at this one here. This is a TV timeout. I've actually used this move before, but I was in complete control when I did it. He's not right there. Jody Shelley's loving it because there's something personal. And tonight, I thought he's been very, very bad on the ice. Forget about the off the ice. On the ice, like this one here, I'm not sure what he's doing, but Lafreniere gets a free chance there. And when a guy like this is emotionally attached to this series and he's not performing the right way, turnover here. As a defense coach or coach, you have to realize he's not giving you his best. He's going to hurt you eventually. Right here, you know, he's going to throw this puck away, and then his guy's going to go to the slot and tip it in. I saw this goal happening. I saw it happening 7-8 minutes before that with bad play after bad play. You have to really be careful when this happens.
You asked me tonight before we came on air if I missed fighting in hockey. That clip right there of him standing there, that makes me miss fighting in hockey. Yeah. I would have absolutely loved to play against this kid.
Well, here's the thing. Peter Laviolette, and I remember this from the 2006 Stanley Cup final against Edmonton. Like, there were some games there in that series where Georges Laroque really ran over Carolina. And Peter Laviolette was like, you know what? We don't engage in that. We don't deal with that. We'll just have to win the way we win. We're not going to fight or anything like that. They didn't really have anyone. And I could see him saying to the Rangers, and this series is proof of it, you are not to engage. He can tell, as you see, that D'Angelo wants revenge so badly he can't control himself. And I guarantee to you, Laviolette has told his guys, you are not to do anything.
You can see Goodrow in that clip. He's not even looking at him, right? He's clearly just not engaging, staying away.
And he's got chances, right? Like, the Rangers let him go. He gets a chance in Carolina. They let him go. He gets a chance because he's a good player on the ice and he produces. But when he's not a good player on the ice, all of a sudden now you're not willing to tolerate all the extra stuff, are you?
And to your point, Elliot, Laviolette said in the lead up to the game, we have to play inside their game. They're very aggressive. Maybe that's what he was talking about, not just pinches and quick ups. Okay, the odd man rushes, Luke.
Well, I thought New York was the better team in that period. Carolina made a push at the end, but where New York feasts on is turnovers and transition. If you turn the puck over against this hockey team, they will make you pay. And everything always moves north for them. So that's a big high flip from the defensemen. They're going to send the wingers going out. Here you go, down the ice. This is shorthanded, like I talked about in the pregame. Lindgren comes down the backside as the third man. That's the defenseman. They're a man short. And when you're in the offensive zone here, you got to be smart here. D'Angelo makes a, you know, poor decision there. And Lafreniere, with the speed, he's gone on another odd man rush with Zibanejad following it up. It was really different. I played in the Western Conference with Edmonton. I remember this now. And we were always D to D to the middle. It was always up low and slow. And I went over to the Eastern Conference and played for Jersey. And it was real, the difference between the two conferences. Everything was up the walls and to speed and flying. And that's where New York has success.
I have to say this. If New York is going to score and tie this game, it's going to be Lafreniere. He is all over the ice tonight. You can tell he's really feeling it. He's been excellent. He should have 2 or 3 goals already. He's been tremendous. And again, one of the biggest storylines this year is how the Rangers have resuscitated his career and how he's found new life. But tonight he is buzzing. And like I said, if anyone's going to tie it for New York, it's going to be that guy.
And he's also been a catalyst for Panarin. The Breadman good last year, but even better with Lafreniere finding his groove. Here's Stefan Nason.
Oh, should we do our overtime picks now or what?
Yes. Sean McKenzie, down to you. or up to you, I have to say.
Stefan, I want to go back just the first few minutes of the game. You're facing the goaltender who's clearly had a great series, but to see one go in early on like that, just how does it change the mindset for the next 38 minutes or so?
Yeah, you know, it's just getting traffic in him. I think all those goals, you know, Kuzi obviously beat him pretty clean there, but, you know, he's a hard goalie to beat. So it's just getting traffic, trying to make it hard on him. And, you know, if he can see pucks, he's gonna save him.
The Rangers score there to make it 3-2. The next shift, you guys come out with a lot of momentum and really control the pace of play. What does it say with the maturity of the group that you guys bounce back the way you did there?
And we've done it all year. We're going to keep doing it. You know, we know what's at stake here. You know, back's against the wall. And, you know, we got to have a hell of a third period.
Stefan, thanks for the time.
Thanks.
It's a big Saturday night. We're on the air from Raleigh. We still have action to come from Denver between the Avs and the Stars. Hockey night in Canada. The Stanley Cup playoffs continues.
NHLShop.ca, the official online store of the NHL and Canada's largest selection of authentic NHL fan gear. Shop now and get today's special offer.
Get on your feet and make some noise!
Inside Out 2 are the official emotions of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Your starting four emotions. We've got joy. And don't forget anger. In the lineup is anxiety. Rounding up the team is embarrassment. Get ready for the most exciting playoffs in sports. And see Disney and Pixar's Inside Out 2, only in theaters, June 14th.
I find it hard to believe you don't know.
I've got to go, okay?
Bye. The beauty you are. But if you don't, just
thanks,
put
Mom.
Down your
yeah.
hands. Because I see you.
You were made to dream about it for years. We were made to help you book it in minutes.
The Jeep No Limits event is here, which means more trails to blaze, more challenges to meet. And right now, enjoy no payments for 90 days. Get into a Jeep Compass with best-in-class horsepower. Or Jeep Grand Cherokee, the most awarded SUV ever. Jeep No Limits is here. Time to test your limits. Get up to 10% off MSRP for up to $8,700 in discounts and no payments for 90 days.
Round two of the Stanley Cup playoffs.
You gotta believe. Another hero will be born tonight.
He is going to be in trouble.
Here we go again.
You'll never feel happy.
On every trip, you can depend on Esso to be the place between places, connecting you to what's next.
When you visit Audible, you can do anything. Chase your thrills. Journey into the great unknown.
Whoa.
And if you're lucky, discover something new to love. Audible, ignite your imagination.
Step into a world far beyond expectations. Beyond exclusive. Beyond exciting. Only Rogers Beyond the Seat gives you exclusive access to unique experiences across Canada. Get more with Rogers.
Yeah, shake it up, change it up, switch it up.
Canadian Ultra Excel. Molson, everyone in.
Sometimes a sub comes along and hits just so right. And then we show it like this, and you think, that can't be $4.99. Guess what? The Subway 6-inch turkey breast sub is only $4.99. Not forever. Offer ends June 23rd.
Men's clothing provided by Jack Victor.
Working our way toward the third period with Harner, Ryan, Louie, and Sean in Raleigh. There comes Cale Makar, and here comes Nathan MacKinnon, the Colorado Avalanche. See the game the other night, Dallas, a 4-0 lead after 40. Avs almost came back to tie.
It's magical. It's a magical game.
See ya. That's good. It is. This is magic. Oh, we got off it too soon. That's the thing about Jamie Benn. Curtains. Anyway, 3-2 Carolina. Our coverage from North Carolina right after this.